I read kind of ended up just as kind of something symbolic of the lyrics and things that we were talking about. And red kind of just embodies like emotion, passion, and love and hate, and a lot kind of the color of life, and all the way down to like to the blood of Christ and the redemption that that has. And so after we had finished on the first record, kind of started preparing new songs and things like that, we still hadn't picked a name. So we wanted something kind of really symbolized all the things that we were talking about, and I think red became it.
Now, as you guys think about your spiritual mission with the band, what do you guys want to do? How do you want to see God use Red for His glory?
I think we really have a heart for the lost, and kind of, I think even more specifically, I mean, in like the church demographic, there's a lot of people that I think have been in the church for years and years and years and kind of lost that connection and can find themselves just disconnected in things and going through things in lives and in their lives, kind of going through the motions and feeling just a little bit lost. I think for us, that's kind of where our heart lies. And we've been fortunate enough to be on a lot of mainstream tours over the last 2 years. And that's really kind of been where we've kind of honed in our mission and who we can really connect with. And that's what's been most successful for us.
Now, how do you feel when you get people calling you up, talking to you in studios, saying, or at shows, coming up to you behind later and saying, hey, you know, this song just so changed my life. Hey, I was in the lowest point and your song came on. You know, how do you respond to that?
We just tell them that's what we do it for. You know, mm-hmm. we're not in the music to seek out fame and fortune. We're here to write music that encourages and pushes people into a different direction. And every time we hear that just lets us can just reaffirms that we're doing the right thing.
Yeah, I think it really encourages us.
It really does, yeah. I love hearing things like that. I mean, to hear that your music connects with people and is engaging is, I mean, that like you said, that's why we do what we do. And so it's incredibly encouraging in our behalf.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the new album, Innocence and Instinct. A couple of diverse influences here. Dante's Inferno and a car wreck. Explain how that works.
Yeah. I think, you know, we were writing so long and working on so long in this record. The last, first record, Innocence, or I'm sorry, End of Silence came out, I mean, almost 2.5 years ago now. So we've been working on this one for quite a while. And the process of that and making this record, just a lot of different things were happening. So the wreck was just kind of something traumatic that happened to us. We got in a really bad wreck last November, so just over a year ago, I think. And we were lucky to make it out alive. I mean, we had a lot of injuries. We lost our drummer. She messed his shoulder up really bad. He's not playing too much anymore. And Dante's Inferno reference was just kind of some stuff that we were reading. And when we were about 70% into the reading process and kind of started stepping back, it became this really cool metaphor kind of for all the things we were talking about and the journeys that we were kind of taking on writing this stuff.
Now, as you guys are getting ready, the new album coming out, the first single, Fight Inside, debuts, you set history. Debuted at number one.
Pretty impressive. I mean, we were really taken back by that. I mean, because it's been a while for us since we've had new material out, and even especially in a live context, it's been 5 years since we've been adding new songs. So for a song to come out and debut at number one, and especially break record like that, it was, I mean, just incredibly humbling. So we're really excited about the new stuff and really glad that everybody's enjoying it. More so than any other song on the record, this is like just kind of the staple of what the entire record is about. You know, you could, if you had to take one song and walk away with what to kind of capture what the whole record embodies, this would be it. I mean, this is kind of about that war inside of each of us and just those things that kind of fight each other and our own personal demons and the struggles that we have continually, whether we believe it or not.